big breaking news there coming in from down south. The crucial DMK executive meet begins in Chennai. The DMK is holding its urgent meeting of its executive committee to condole the death of party president M. Karunanidhi. The meeting also comes a day after former union minister and Karunanidhi's son M.K. Aragiri challenged brother M.K. Stalin's elevation as the party president. Pramod now joins me live for more on this. Pramod, there seems to be high anticipation at this meeting. We're seeing scenes outside the party office there. Of course, these are unprecedented in a lot of ways. Is the stage set for the elevation of M.K. Stalin?
Well, it surely is. On Friday, it was announced that the DMK will conduct its special executive committee meeting. And right now, we're standing inside this DMK headquarters. And what's happening here is that we have 16 head executive members, almost 400 executive members. And in this place right now, 1,500 people from DMK, special invitees, executive committee members, and special executive committee members are present. And T.K. Zalangawan, the MP from DMK, is reading out the condolence message for Karunanidhi, the party chief's death. This was the actual agenda of the executive committee meeting, but this became very crucial after what M.K. Stalin's brother Aragiri did yesterday. He went ahead, went to Karunanidhi's resting place yesterday and gave out two important points. One stating that the loyal, true followers of DMK and his father are with him, and that he wanted to express the remorse about the way the party is being led, and that's why he went over there. Almost like OPS going to JS Memorial and conducting a meditation, he went over there and after that he said this. Now Aragiri is not in Chennai, but M.K. Stalin, after the death of Karunanidhi, becomes the working president, and there is a lot of chance that he could be elevated as a president. M.K. Stalin earlier said that that is not the agenda of the meet, but as we speak right now, the condolence message is being read and anything could be expected after the message has been delivered.
Also, Pramod, there are the challenges before M.K. Stalin is also multifold. On one hand, he might have to fight it out with his elder brother for the succession to the party. But also, on the other hand, he has to even see whether he has the gain or he has the kind of interest in the party. Does he hold the people's mandate when it comes to holding a post which his father has held for decades together?
Well, it surely is. In the period of 2014-15, Aragiri was evicted from the party by Karunanidhi, and slowly what happened after that is that Stalin started replacing his loyalists into the party with his father and Aragiri. That is a kind of like claim that's been occurring. And even 6 months earlier, the southern district heads and the people who are supposed to lead the district secretary mayor's post and everything, they were allegedly replaced. Aragiri's followers were replaced by Stalin. These were the allegations inside the party as well. But right now, what's going to be the issue is that within 2 months, that is 60 days period, the party's working president has to be nominated and elected, which means Stalin will become the party's president. Presumably, that is the talk we have right now. At that point, Stalin is right now holding the position of the treasurer and the youth wing leader. These two positions will become vacant and the positions have to be filled. And not just that, there is also a word claiming that K. Anbaragan, who is the general secretary of the party, will also resign. If that happens, he will be replaced. So these are the very important, crucial positions of the party, and that is where Aragiri's yesterday statement comes into play, claiming that Aragiri wants a stake in those positions. That's why he gave out these messages yesterday from his party, father's resting place.
All right, many thanks, Pramod, for getting us those details. We'll, of course, come back to you for all the action that is taking place from outside the DMK's executive council meeting that is taking place. Of course, there are many speculations that is rife, but is the stage set for M.K. Stalin is the big question. We'll, of course, come back to you for more, Pramod.